Jai Shri Gurudev. So in last class I already discussed about coordinate geometry, how to plot the points and also a distance formula and also section formula. Okay, related problems already discussed about in last video. This video, so in this video we are going to discuss the different concepts related to continuation of that coordinate. So midpoint, next concept is midpoint. Okay, already in last class we discussed the section formula. Now what is the section formula? If any line AB or AB, A is one point and B is another point, line joining is AB and P is the any point between A and B on the line, otherwise on the line P, okay, on the line AB, P is any point. So how to calculate P in section formula already derived. See, P is equals to mx2 plus nx1, mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n, okay, m by 2 plus n by 1 divided by m plus n, m plus n, okay. So this already discussed in a previous class. Okay, if the point P in between A and B, this is called internal section formula, internally and the P. So if the point P is outside, otherwise like this, either either A, this is A, this is A, this is B, okay, the P divides AB, the P divides AB externally in the ratio 2:3, and then so the point P is outside, 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 so therefore derivative this is outside, this is also our section formula. So what is the formula? Well, this case is there means, okay, I have to say minus, what is that formula? Mx2, mx2 minus nx1 divided by m plus n, comma, m minus n, and m by 2 minus n by 1 divided by m minus n. So this is the formula. Externally means, if the condition, externally condition is there, you have to use this formula. Internally means like this formula is there, like a problem is there, you have to use the internal problem is there, you have to use this formula. Okay, my dear students, please keep it mind. Okay, but so many purposes we are using this internal form, so that's why I am concentrating on something. Let us consider this one. The line AB, the point P divides AB in the ratio MHDN means the point P is known as like this. Okay, now I have to discuss the midpoint. Midpoint and the range. You know the what is the meaning of midpoint? Midpoint is the middle point. Okay, na? Andre, first suppose, nodi, ille 2:3 iran koli. 2:3. This is now the P is not a midpoint. Why? Because idu two parts is three parts. Midpoint. Midpoint aagbe andre ena agutte? So distance, e distance, e distance is same. Therefore, now 2:2. Then you can tell that P is the midpoint. My dear students, I have understood. So 2:2 ratio and divide by 2:2. 2 1 2 1 1 is 2 1 1. So therefore, for midpoint, m value is 1 and n value is 1. So therefore, m is equals to 1, n is equals to 1. And A is considered as x1 by 1. And B should be A2y. I have to consider like this. A and B. Okay. And I have to substitute these values here. P is equal to. Now, what is P? P is a midpoint. We are considering like that. Why? Because the ratio is same. Ratio is different means not a midpoint. Ratio is same. That's why. N1. So therefore, 1 into x1, x2. 1 into x1, sorry, 1 into x2, x2, 1 into x1, x1, divided by m plus n, 1 plus 1 is what? 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. Comma. Okay. Next. Here. M is equals to 1. N is equals to 1. So y2 plus y1 divided by 1 plus 1. 2. Right. So y2 plus y1 divided by 2. This is very very important formula, midpoint formula. Understood or not? So midpoint formula. So this is the x1, x2 plus x1, otherwise x1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Okay. Related problems, we'll see one some more problems related to midpoint. Okay, now we'll see the problems. See, here A point is there and B point is there. Okay. We have to calculate the midpoint between the line joining AB. They will ask like this. Okay. So already know the formula. So first you have to write x1 y1, x2 y2. This is x2 y2. Okay, x1 y1, x2 y2. Okay. So midpoint formula. Midpoint formula P is equals to midpoint. Midpoint P is equals to x1 plus x2 divided by 2, comma. Okay. Next. Y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Okay, this is the formula. X1, x2 or x2, x1, both are same, that's right. Okay. X1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Okay. Here, x1, y1, x2, y2 is there now. Substitute these values here. Substitute point. Tell me. Now see. Substitute these values. Substitute these values here. X1 is what? 2 plus 10. 10 divided by 2. Okay. 4 plus 6. 4 plus 6 divided by 2. 4 plus 6 divided by 2. Okay. So calculate the value. So 2 plus 10, 12. 2 plus 10, 12. 12 by 2 is what? 6. 12 by 2, 6. So 4 plus 6, 10 by 2, 5. So this is the midpoint line joining AB. Like that you have to get. My dear students, please keep it in your mind. This is very very important formula. What is the formula? Midpoint formula. X1 plus x2 divided by 2, comma y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Okay, we will see the next. So my dear students, do it. These two as a homework. Midpoint. I have to calculate the midpoint of the following. A 2 comma 9, B 6 comma 1. Midpoint, you have to calculate the midpoint. And A minus 1 comma 3, 5 comma 5. Second point. This is A and this is B. Okay. So you have to calculate the midpoint. Midpoint for the these two problems. Understood or not? We will see the next concept called area of the triangle. See, my dear students, see the next concept. Area of the triangle. Area of the triangle. You can calculate the area of the triangle. If given input is different, you can easily calculate. So, if base if base and height is given, base and height is given, you can easily calculate the area of the triangle by using half BH area of the triangle. Okay. If in coordinate geometry, if three points are, these are the vertices A, are the vertices. If A, B, C vertices are given, how to calculate the area of the triangle? Okay, in coordinate geometry, one formula is there. Using that formula, we can calculate the area of the triangle. What are the vertices here? A, x1, y1, B, x2, y2, C, x3, y3. What is that formula means? Area of the triangle, A is equals to see, half into area A is equals to half into x1 into y2 minus y1 plus x2 into x2 into y3 minus y1 plus and x1 x2 over x3 into y1 minus y1 minus y2. Okay, like that you have to simplify. Okay, so this is the formula. Okay, by using this formula, we can easily calculate the area of the triangle. My dear students, here x1 into y2 minus not y1, y3, y2 minus y3, sorry. So, yes, another time, see. Area is equal to half into x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 x3 into y1 minus y2. Okay, now? Ah, see. See, how to memorize this one, sir? One technique is there, see. X1, x2, x3. Okay, now? X half, half is there, we will give it. X1, x2, x3. Understood? One comes after 1, 2, 3, no? 1, 2, 3, cycling. Wow. 1 angle, okay. 2, 3. 2 angle, okay. 3, mathe 1. 3, idre, mathe 1, 2, okay. Cycling. Itara, okay. Okay, like this. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, rotate. It will be rotate. Cyclic order, okay. So, 1 means first 1, 2, 3. 2 first means 2, 3, 1. 3 first means 3, 1, 2, like that. Okay, first x1, this is x related, x, 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 and these two are, these three are y related. Now you tell me, very easy, no? Technique, this technique you have to memorize. Okay, why I had to memorize, you have to memorize. This the technique you have to memorize. How it will be see? X1, half into modulus, modulus. Area should be positive always. Okay, if negative comes, modulus becomes, makes the value positive. That's right, modulus. X1 into y2 minus y3, y2 minus y3 plus x2 into 2 y, y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1, 3 I y1 minus y1. Like that, we have to memorize. My dear students, keep it this mind, okay? Keep it in this mind, okay? Very easy, have to memorize. By using this one, we can easily calculate the area of the triangle. How it will be seen? We will take one example, okay? So, let us consider one problem, see. I considered the three points, see. Point A, B and C. Okay, these are the three points. You have to calculate the area of the triangle by using these points. See. A, B, C points. What is the formula? Tell me another time.
So, area of the triangle A is equal to half into x1 into y2 minus y3 plus
y2 minus y3 plus x2 into
y, y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y3. So, like that, we have to evaluate.
Okay, this is the formula. By using this formula, we can calculate. Okay. See.
This is x1. This is x2, y1. x1, y1. This is x2, y2. x3, y3.
Okay. Substitute these values here.
Half into. X1 is what? 4. 4 into. Okay. Into, okay, y2 means minus 2, minus 2, y3 minus 6, plus x2, x2 is what, x2 here, x2, x2 3 into y3, 6, minus y1, 4, minus 4, plus x3, minus 3 into, minus 3 into, y1, 4, minus y2, minus 1, minus 2, plus 1. Like that, it happens.
Okay, simplify it, you can get the answer. Okay,
half into 4, into minus 2, minus 6, minus 8, plus 3 into 6, minus 2, okay, minus 3 into 6. Like that, you have to
simplify. Okay, how to simplify the value?
See, half into 4, 8, 32, minus 32, 3, 2, 6, 3, 6, 18,
okay, like that we have to simplify,
this is the modulus, and, see, is equal to half into minus 32 plus 6, minus 8, okay, now, 32 minus 32 minus 18 is 50, minus 50, minus 50 plus 6, minus 50 plus 6, minus 40 minus
44. So 44 minus will become what? Positive. 44 by 2 is equal to 22. Like that you have to simplify. Okay na, my dear students. So either you go, I have to simplify the area of the triangle. Okay? Now try simplify what put in a line with that. Can I do it? Okay. I'll give a homework for you. Okay. So my dear students, do this one as a homework. Okay. A 4, 4, B 3, -2. C -3, 16. Okay, you have to find out the area of the triangle. Okay, which vertices? These are the vertices. A comma B comma C are the vertices. The answer is 27. Check it once. Okay, after doing, you check the answer. 27 coming. Understood or not? Okay. So, my dear students, so learn all these things. So Monday onwards, we will start the syllabus sets. Okay, put one notes. Sets, I'll start the syllabus on Monday. Sets chapter will start Monday. So, you put one notes and write down the notes. I'll give the notes also. Okay, I'll post the video. I'll share the video. Watch that video and notes given now posted. Notes, I have to write the notes. Notes separately put in it. Video separate again, observe Monday. Any doubts, doubt. We have to comment on this below video. Otherwise, you can post in a WhatsApp. I'll clarify the doubts. Okay. So Monday onwards we'll start the syllabus. Mathematics first PUC syllabus. Okay, now my dear students. Thank you. So one notes and test book. If you have any test book, please purchase NCERT test book only. Don't purchase some other test books, okay? Test book, NCERT test book, four test books are there, you can take from your seniors, okay? One NCERT, first PUC test book, and one notes, okay? And you have to purchase these two things and you have to maintain Monday onwards. If you have any doubts, you can ask, okay? Thank you, yes, good day. Thank you very much.